Yo, how's it going, guys? We're back for another TOS video. So today, finally, there's times two drop rate for this Xuan Yuan's Earth Extra. So I finally get to do up the video that I forgot to record. So, I'm going in with dual Hephaestus, so fire grid deck. So I'll just explain along the way. Right. So forgive me for such sloppy rune spinning at the beginning, because I have no idea what I'm doing as well. I'm not stalling for CD, but I'm just really, I don't know what am I actually doing. Right, so it's funny how I'm playing a grid team and then I have like almost zero fire runes on the board. Alright, here we go. So the real thing starts now. So in this video, there is a few very unfortunate events that is very close, very near death experience. So I don't know, sometimes my rune just don't fall properly in place. Right, so as you can see, first mini boss is Enchanted Shield, so this won't be a very big problem for grid team, isn't it? Alright, so just do your normal rune spin since you have plenty of enchanted rune and just move on. Alright, so every Xuan Yuan series extra will have one stage like this where this small little mob will drop their card at level 10. So you can just feed it to the various Xuan Yuan card that have the same active. Right, so you have this Terra Metallic Dragon with some high defense there. I didn't really check what's the defense for this guy, but then since I'm running a fire grid, it should be easy to break through the defense with a few sky drops, right? Like this. So easily broken through his defense. So even if you don't break through his defense, by hitting 1-1-1 very easily, you can just slaughter him by just take small turn. Right, so for this extra, turn limit is not an issue, so you can just chill on the turn limit because you will hardly run out of rounds for this extra. Unlike this fire extra that I've been trying for very long. Diablo team doesn't work, so I'm just waiting for my Poseidon to come. Right, so for now, mobs will have effects, so really have to take note of that piggy over there. That pig has damage reflect. So just try to aim it first if you are using like a non-grid deck. Right, so is this the second mini boss? So-called second mini boss. So 2 second rune movement time with this Soul Stone. Right, so Soul Stone actually have very little HP. So is this pig in the center that have quite a huge amount of HP. Right, so unfortunately, I did not take him down in one turn, and then I have a bit of cock up here. Like my runes aren't falling properly, and then didn't manage to kill the pig, and then this Soul Stone just keeps spawning. Right, as you can see, 4 runes, no sky drop. Right, and then no sky drop again. But as you can see, I'm still chilling my rune spinning because I told you, this round limit isn't a big problem. It's not an issue at all for this extra. So I'm just taking my time and just kind of slowly self-spin, do a slow self-spin, and then just try to store up your fire runes as well. So in this extra, there is pretty much a few traps that you need to take note of. So one wrong move, and then you're dead. Right, so we're almost there. I'll just explain when the stage comes. So another round of mini mob. So this pig will drop the card if I'm not wrong. Is it the pig? Yes. Yep, the pig. Alright, battle 11. Do we have a mini boss here? Yes, so Yang Jian here is has chosen 1 CD. Right, so this one, you definitely have to one hit kill this Yang Jian. If not, you're dead. So if you think this this stage here is difficult, you wait till the back part. Right, so since it's the front few mini bosses, his HP isn't considered to be a lot. So but nonetheless, do not underestimate his HP. Just overkill him if you have to, just to be safe, because he's a Trojan mob. Okay, Soulstone, battle 13. Right, as you can see, this is one of the stages that I almost died. Yes, I almost died to this mini mobs, because see, as you can see, my last hit just nice killed the two damage reflect mobs. I cannot imagine dying to that man. Right, so we have this Kong Golem, which is a very big nuisance here, especially in this video. Right, so the side Golem actually does only like one damage if you don't break through the defense. And then take note, you have to kill the Kong Golem when these two. You have to kill the Kong Golem together with the side minions. Right, so if you kill the Kong Golem with the side minions alive, they will both explode, dealing 10k damage each. Right, so as you can see now, I'm struggling a bit. Trying to take both of all these mobs down together. Kong Golem together with the minion. Right, as you can see, low on HP. And I accidentally do a single attack. So that leaves one minion alive. So this is a very awkward situation where you have to, I don't know how did I actually survive this. So okay, what I did is I just do a self spin there. And then I tried to align that three heart runes over there. Right, so here I'm like thinking, shit, I need to re-record these things, stupid extra again. Right, so obviously this amount of runes is not enough, so I thought of my Draconic Compulsion here. Which is quite a silly thing to do, but then I have no choice. Right, so here I'm just basically dissolving one whole chunk of fire runes first, and then stocking up fire runes for the next round, which is pretty much unnecessary, but then I'll just do it just in case, you know. Right, so broke through the side minion's defense, so that's very lucky. Right, so the next battle is actually mini mobs. So by having a whole board of fire runes, it's just, I don't know, good to look at, but then it really does nothing lah. But then the good news is I've actually have a decent amount of fire runes on the board now. Right, so battle 16 is the biggest trap of all. So you look at this guy. He's pretty much the same as the mini mob in the yokai series. So once you start attacking this guy, you have to one hit kill it. So in summary, if you touch him and he's not dead, then you're dead. Right, so it's a relief I have such amount of sky drop. So say goodbye to this mini boss, then let's move on. Right, so make sure that your HP is pretty high when you move on, because we have this next mini boss with Spam Trojan. So her attacks get higher and higher every turn. So as you can see, I've actually turned on media already. So the damage that she's giving me will be pretty much 1.5 times higher than normal. So as you can see, I'm just trying my best to trigger this Hephaestus amelioration every turn. Right, hopefully to kill her off. Yep, done. Right, so battle 18. Battle 18 is a trap also. As you can see, this Fusion Mark 2 have enchanted shield, but his enchanted shield is a little bit different. So if you dissolve one row of runes that is not enchanted, that damage will actually be reflected back at you, which is pretty much a one hit KO. So as you can see, every fire that I dissolve, there it must contain an enchanted rune. If not, there will be a damage reflect back to you. So for grid, pretty much you have enchanted everywhere, so there's not something to worry about. So in fact, I wanted to go in with Osiris team and then I died here, not knowing what in the world happened. Yep, it's because of the enchanted runes, non-enchanted rune damage reflex. Okay, so we're done. Let's move on. Second last mini boss. Pretty much last mini boss because we are almost to the boss. Right, so this what's this guy's name? I can't remember. Jiang Shangdi or Zhang Zhang Ziya, yes. Right, this guy locks God active, and then with every God in your team, his attack will actually increase. So I've actually tried, it's really impossible not to have any gods in your team. So his skull there is just definite kill. Right, so as you can see, pretty much I actually plan to use Cerberus on the first HP bar of the boss, and then Scrooge on the second HP bar of the boss. Right, so the reason why I turned on Cerberus here is because I've actually taken a look at my Dragonic Compulsion and I said, oh, it's back. So yep, I turn it on now. Not because I needed that extra damage, but then as you can see, I'm actually starting to store my fire runes again. That's what I did in the first Dragonic Compulsion. So yep, Dragonic Compulsion is not only meant to do damage boost, but then you can use it to store your fire runes for next round. Right, whatever runes that you need. So this is one trick for Dragonic Compulsion. Right, so as you can see, pretty much I have the whole board of fire runes. So first HP bar, once he's dead, he will mask my whole entire board. Not revealing them even once. Right, so with this cell spin, with that amount of sky drop and fire rune, say goodbye to the first HP bar. And then there you go, whole board is masked. So just turn on Scrooge, whole board to fire. Hephaestus, Zeus Link skill, and then Hephaestus himself. Then you can just watch your fire rune fall so nicely and then just say goodbye to this Earth Extra. GG. Right, so with the correct team, this Earth Extra isn't a very big problem. Round limit, as I said earlier, not a big problem as well. Stage wise, just have to really be careful of this rune spin and then you'll be fine. Right, so this will be the Earth Extra for this Shen Yuan series. Yep, leave a like if you enjoyed this video. I'm gonna end this video right here and then I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!